It is natural to think that the higher number and higher price tag means a better device. Even though that might be the case here, by how much and how far does this go when you compare the Samsung Galaxy A32 against the Samsung Galaxy A52, and which should you buy? You want to find out? Without taking much of your time, yo guys, let's get started. As has become the custom for my comparison videos, I love to touch on the items from the boxes, and every accessory seems to be about the same for the smartphones. Both having the smartphones, TPU cases, USB-C connectors, SIM ejection tools, 15 watts charging brick, and the paperwork. When it comes to design, both have this all new look at the rear, kind of borrowing from the designs on the S lineup this year, but this time, both devices are made out of plastic, and they weigh almost the same. A less premium material as far as the flagship standards go. Don't get me wrong here, the matte finish and the gloss finish you get from both the A52 and the A32 respectively feel awesome. Is this design something a lot of people would like? Clearly it is. Things begin to drift apart when you flip the smartphones to their fronts. You get from both smartphones amazing 90Hz refresh rates on Super AMOLED Full HD panels with 800 nits of brightness, basically about the same specs on paper. But things might not always be the same in all use cases for these displays. By the way, you get a slightly larger display on the A52 here, a 6.47 inch panel, while the A32 has a 6.4 inch panel. Under these displays lie the fingerprint sensors for both smartphones. Not the fastest, as I would always say, but they get the job done. Now, you would get smoother display experience from the A52, all thanks to the Snapdragon 720G chipset, as opposed to the less equipped G80 processor for certain 90Hz tasks on this display. Also for the design, you would notice the Infinity U cutout housing the selfie camera on the A32, while the Galaxy A52 has the Infinity O, or cutout camera placement for selfies. Some other notable mentions that make the A52 superior in terms of the build quality, hardware or design in general would include the stereo speakers you get from the A52 and the IP67 rating, meaning you get water and dust resistance on the smartphone. Performance is another aspect where the A32 takes a beating, and for configuration and specs, you have 6GB of RAM, 128GB of internal storage, Android 10, One UI 3.1 for both devices, but the A52 here has the beefier Snapdragon 720 chip, and while the A32 gives you the MediaTek Helio G80 processor. Obviously, better processing on the part of the A52, and this transcends to gameplay and how the smartphone handles the 90Hz refresh in some cases. Sometimes an app launch speed test, although I usually wouldn't use that as a yardstick for the faster device, and also how the smartphones process the images coming from the same specs of camera sensors. Speaking of which, for images and cameras, both smartphones have about the same specs in terms of configuration for their rear camera arrays. That is 64MP main lens, 5MP depth sensor, and a 5MP macro lens. Where things begin to differ are in the ultra wide and front cameras. You get a 12MP for the A52 and an 8MP for the A32 in terms of the ultra wide camera. While the A52 has a 32MP front facing camera, you get a 20MP for the A32. Now, the difference in hardware doesn't end there, as you have OIS on the A52, making it possible to get sharper images and more stabilized video footage. There's no way you won't see the difference in camera quality between these two smartphones, as the photos from the A52 are always more pleasant, better contrast, and generally the better camera smartphone. This trend continues up to the video from both smartphones, and the video from both the rear and the front of these cameras can be recorded at up to 4K 30fps on the A52, while the A32 still maintains a 1080p resolution for the rear cameras and for the front cameras too. The battery is one area where the A32 would outshine the A52. You get 5000mAh battery from the A32, while the A52 comes bundled with a 4500mAh power pack. Both devices come with 15W chargers out of the box, but the good thing about the A52 here would be the support for 25W fast charging, meaning you can easily juice up this device, the A52, if you decide to purchase a faster charger for your smartphone. But in general, for a single charge, the A32 definitely outlasts the A52, but not by a far stretch. So I got the A32 here for 113,500 naira, roughly $240, and the A52 here for 139,500 naira, roughly $300. There's about a $50 difference in price for the smartphones. So which of those devices should you get with the prices in view? You definitely know by now, as it is straightforward. The Samsung Galaxy A52 here is a better device and offers you more value for every dollar you spend. I tend to feel like the A32 is quite overpriced, and that sweet spot in the A series right now should be the A52. You get better cameras, better build quality, better overall performance, and better value for money. Was this video helpful? Let me know in the comment section below. Hit that like button and do not forget to subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. I'm gonna catch you guys in the next one. Kawida Day.